Hi everyone, it's Wednesday the 29th of May. It is what, 8:30 in the morning. We get to leave a little bit later because the kids are on holiday this week and they're at holiday club, so I don't have to walk them there. It's only around the corner, it's only at school, but I just drive around there and then go straight to work to save walking there, walking back, and then get in the car. Excuse me, so I get to work a little bit earlier, which is good because I just had a bank holiday and it's busy. But I've got lots of stuff to show you, so I thought I'd pop on and just do a bit of a finished items video. Where to start? I'll start with what I've made before. So I made another of Rel. Rel is from the Dabbling Hook. Hi Rel. Made another one of her octopuses. And this is made using darn good yarn that Z sent me. Hi Z! It's beautiful, it's silk. So this is the most luxurious toy I have ever made. But the little ball or skein or whatever that had wasn't enough to do anything sort of big or wearable particularly. So I thought, how about make a stinking cute octopus with it? That's that out of the bottom of it. Super cute. So that's finished item number one. I have lots of finishes, lots. I had this finished before but didn't get to show you because somebody who's sitting behind the camera had pinched it. This is from the Whimsical Stitches book that Kim sent me. Hi Kim. Yes, I know, it's yours. But donut with a little face, super cute. Yeah, I made him, Jack nicked him, straight away. There you go. We caught it, well done. And then I was clearing out, they've been very good. I had Thursday, Friday and Monday off with them because Monday was a bank holiday. So I had 5 days off and they were quite good letting me crochet because the weather was a bit naff and we didn't really go out anywhere. What did we do Thursday? Went to the library, went to see my sister, we had a picnic in the garden. Friday. Oh, Tony's friend slept over Thursday night and had him Friday. So yeah, they were busy being boys and stuff. Yeah, so I got quite a bit of crochet time in between getting the room ready for sleepovers and stuff. So I cleared out my crochet tub and this dude was in there. This is a Cyclops pattern. I can't think who it's by. I'll find it and link it below. To be perfectly honest, I wasn't massively like into the pattern. It's quick, but I was just a bit like, I think he looks cute now. But he got his legs on and I put the eye in and I thought I'm going to have to finish it because I've used an eye. That's like, there's no going back now. You've used it. So I found the arms and him in the tub and thought, well, I'll sew the arms on. And I thought he needs something else, some horns or something. So I was looking through, I was talking to Jack about it. And then, you know, I said for Pinch, the goblin, I thought I'd made the warts and I couldn't find them. Found them in the bottom of my tub. So Jack wanted like, what do you call them? Goat horns. Yeah, goat horns, like curled ones. And I was like, that might be a bit of a faff to do. And I said, what if I just sew these green horns on and you can have it sold? So this is for Jack as well. So that's two toys he's had off me this week. Oops, there you go, got it.
I've got a donut hand down and I can't move it.
And then Kim, again, of Kim Crafty's, you've just dropped it, Kim Crafty's Corner, enabled me further and said, ooh, check this spring dragon pattern out. And I did post it on Instagram and said the pattern was free. It was when I got it, but it's quite new. I'll link to it below. It's very new, like 19th of May or something like that it came out. So I must have got it while it was on this, you know, for free when it was first released. So I do apologise, it is a pay-for pattern now, but it's about $2 or something like that. And here it is. Look how cute he is. Such a cute face. So there is an option to put two legs or four legs or no legs. Because he's in... I couldn't be bothered. It's not really bad. So you do cute, like, edging on the wings and super easy spine down the back. It does say to put two nostrils on, like just two slits for the nostrils. And I did those first because it says to do it within the head, when you first make the head. Could I get the eyes to look right with the nostrils on? So I took the nostrils off and I think it looks super cute. So there he is. This is Karen Simply Soft I used. I don't know the colour. Probably lime and don't know. But it's very cute. So check the pattern out. It worked up quickly. The head and the body and the tail is all one piece. And then you pick up and do the wings. You pick up along the body. You don't have to sew them on. You do have to do some stitching in between, because you're working back and forth and then you join in, so you've got a bit of a gap. But I like it, it's very good. I'll show you the little things and I'll show you the big things. So last night, or yesterday, I decided to make up one of my little teddy bears that I make. And this is using my, it was the favourite colour of, I believe it's Dancing Baby, not Magic Light. And it's the one I kept trying to buy and kept buying the wrong colour because I was buying Magic Light and it was Dancing Baby. Because I like the colours in it, but I've noticed this pack I got, the colours are really like speckled, and like on there, it's not green, it's got green and pink in it, and it's just not as, it's not as nice as the first lot I had. And the original lot I had, Amy sent me. Hi Amy, of Amy's Woolly World Creations. Amy's Woolly World? Yeah. Green Feather 7 on Instagram, Amy Gibson. So I made this up. I need to put felt on for his mouth and for his tummy patch. Does anybody know where I put my felt? Because I don't.
In the sewing machine.
My felt, no. So I need to find my felt. I've tied it. Can't find it. Anyway, so I'll find my felt and I'll put a nose and tummy patch on that. I might do it in different colours, because the original pattern that I work from is in plain colour, not variegated, and they're super cute, so maybe I should make some plain ones. And then I just finished this dude this morning. It's a mini teddy bear. Look how cute he is. He's got a little bobble tail. And these are very... tutorial on YouTube, so I will link to it. But this, right, it's finish off and leave a 40 inch tail, and I thought, that's really long. Why would you leave a 40 inch tail? It's tiny. You weave your end through and then you chain and make the arm, then you weave that end through, come out here and make the other arm, you make the legs. I think you make the tail as well, or with you your end chain. No sew. Well, no sewing for the arms, legs and tail, which is super clever. And then you just add the ears and the mouth circle. But in the video, the lady cuts all the ends and glues that on, but I've actually stitched it on. So that could be done with felt, either way. Yeah, they're cute. Jack's nabbed this one as well. He wants a keyring on it. My keyrings, I ordered some, because I went through my yarn tub, and I have none. Unless I put them somewhere and I'll find them, but I ordered 50 more, so they came yesterday. My keyrings come yesterday, Jack.
They came the other day.
Yesterday, didn't they?
Yeah.
Yeah. Sun's coming out now. I don't need them, it's okay. So he's going to go on a keyring for Jack, and then I might do some plain colours, and then yeah. I need to pick. Oh, Jack, can you pass me my... the little suitcase thing. I was thinking I need to make some more things out of the 100 mini days of amigurumi. The little, like, case full of amigurumis. The one that had the elephant in.
That one.
Lewis's mum, yeah. They're my key rings, just from Amazon. I'll link to it below. Speaking of Amazon, thank you. There's, like, I think three people have ordered through one of my links to buy books. Thank you. What do I need to show? There we go, candy floss. So this is the candy floss. Candy floss from the 100 Days of Mini Amigurumi Volume 1. I need to get a hairbrush on it, but I actually looked in the drawer under my bed where I used to have my hairbrushes, and they've all gone because of that monster there.
I've
nicked
one.
All my hairbrushes. So I just need to brush this out so it's a little fluffier. So cotton candy or candy floss. That's one on the list that the boys picked out for me to make. I'm still not. I'm going to make something for Tobin's friend for a party.
Good. Oh, Mom, here's one that you
on
want
Saturday,
to give
him. Yeah, he wants to give him the cactus that I made a while ago. I think he wants to give him the seahorse.
These are mine.
No, the cotton candy. The candy floss isn't yours. Jack's stealing my stuff. Anyway.
Okay, I won't have the cotton candy, but these two and the bear.
No, you've had three things. You've got the Cyclops, the donut, and this teddy bear. No, no. See what I deal with. Anyway, on to the big finishes. So, if you haven't... It's glue, Jack.
It looks like a baby bowl.
See, that's my worry. I showed you this last time, didn't I? Someone said I should sew glue, like the word glue on the back. I might have to, because... little face. I do like his little
face.
It
looks like a baby.
Anywho, so last week...
And it has milk in.
Jack, shush me. To celebrate her birthday week, Valerie from Old Soul Crocheting. Hi, Valerie. Did a mega week of patterns. So if you missed her videos last week, unfortunately you missed out on a sale on all these new patterns. But she released 6 patterns in the space of a week. One of them was a free pattern for the Chubby Panda, which I adore. Oh, I love it. And then she released Amber Bunny. Brain fade. The Unicorn Hobby Horse. What was it? Otter. There we go. Jack, don't do that. Angie Otter, Wendy Narwhal, and the big sheep, the big version of the sheep, which is amazing. It's a sheep called Shelly Sheep, I think. So I was lucky enough to be picked as a pattern tester, and I didn't get it done in time because we had a mix-up with emails and stuff, which was a bummer. But I have made one now. I am so delighted. Well, I have made two. But I absolutely love this pattern. Now, this pattern, the narwhal pattern, will be... So it was sold singly last week. However, it's now going to be bundled with the whale, because it's similar in shape. It's just the whale's got a water spout, and I don't think it's got fins. But this is Wendy Narwhal. How cute. Look at the fin. I love the tail. So, so cute. So, the little horn. This is Lolly's, a yarn up from Lolly's and Aaron roll, which I think are very similar. If not, they are Hobby Lobby yarns. And this is the Aldi blanket yarn. And then some fleece that Amber sent to me. Thank you, Amber. Amber's from You Are Crochet. I will link to her channel below. I'll link to Valerie as well. So it's got cute little fins and a hair on it. So this is super cute. I love the shaping here. You don't have to do any sewing to get that shape. It's just lovely. And the shape of these fins is just great. I love it. So, that's Wendy Narwhal. I think he's a boy for that one. He seems a boy. And then, oh, look at the birdie fleece. I believe Carol sent me this. Carol, who sent me this? I think so. I've got all my fleece in the plan bag that Amber sent me. Where has she been sitting? So, birdie fleece. And then this is the pink stripe, I think, yarn from Aldi. And I wasn't sure how it was going to work up. But I think it's really cute. I started and I did the first few rows and I was like, I don't know if these colours are going to look alright. But I think it's really sweet. Don't you, Jack? Think it's sweet?
Why?
It's not yours. Oh my word, this
when
kid.
When are you going to make me a narwhal?
After the craft fair. So, yeah, there's...
How dare you?
If it doesn't sew, we can have it. But so there we go. That's my... I've got 2 narwhals, 1 octopus, a dragon, 2 teddy bears, a toy-stealing child. But yeah, so it's been
and
a productive few days.
Another toy-stealing child in the other room.
Mm. Excuse me, it's not as bad as you. So yeah, that's what I've got to show you really. So please go check out Valerie's website for the patterns. The sheep is just amazingly gorgeous. I like the idea of the hobby horse, and I think my niece, Felicity, would love one, but I don't think her mum would love me for giving her a stick to bang around the house. So, yeah, I'll hold off on that. They've just moved, well, not just moved. Last year they moved into a new house, so I'll save her paintwork and stuff for now. And the otter is adorable. They're all just amazing. So please go check her out. Give her some love. Links to everyone I've mentioned will be below. Link to the key rings. I think it was £4.63 for 50 of them. So yeah, I'm going to go and get these lot ready. What time is it now? 8:45. So yeah, I need to round them up. We need to drop them off. Excuse me, I need to get to work, get to the gym. No swimming today, because we changed day to Tuesday, so swimming is out of the way for the week. yeah, so I hope you're all okay. I hope you had a good long weekend. If you're in the States, you had Memorial Day weekend. Yeah, over here, and you had the bank holiday. Well, I know you didn't have nice weather, because we didn't have nice weather. Unless it was, you had somewhere that the sun shone, didn't you? Yeah, anyway, so take care, and I'll catch up with you all again soon. Bye, everyone.